Welcome to the Global from Asia podcast, where the daunting process of running an international business from Hong Kong is broken down into straight up actionable advice. And now, your host, Michael Michelini.
Thank you, everybody, for tuning in to another Global from Asia podcast. Have a few visitors that are heading through to Hong Kong on their way to DCBKK, which is the Dynamite Circle yearly conference. I'm going to try my best to catch up with them while they're in Hong Kong, and it's always fun to meet listeners and get to know everybody better. I really wanted to go to that DCBKK event. I thought I was going to make it, but being a new dad with these duties and also some local business deals, I have to stay local. It's really an amazing event. And Dan Andrews is amazing, and he motivated me at the event last year to start this actual podcast. So we all should thank him for that. Maybe shoot him a tweet at TropicalMBA on Twitter and thank him for me. I'm also working hard on his book. It's in the third draft, and my editor friend Russell Smith is checking it over in detail now, expecting to release on November 1st. If you want to join the newsletter, you'll also be the first to know, and you can check out the page on globalfromasia.com/book. Check it out, leave your email, and I'll keep you posted. All right, enough of that. Let's go into this show. In this episode, we have Andrew Young. He's the VP of Marketing and Sales at the Hong Kong Science and Technology Park. This science park is beautiful and a massive tech center in Hong Kong. He welcomes anybody to come and visit. I'm also going to put some pictures on the show notes, so check them out at globalfromasia.com/episode54. They also have an event in December, and after the interview, I'll give you some of the details if you're interested and able to go. So without further ado, let's get into the show. Also, quick disclaimer, I'm a little bit embarrassed to say, but I forgot my microphone when I went out to meet them, and it was already 3 hours to get there from where I am in. I had to do it without a microphone, but the quality was done really well as best we could, and I think it's still very good content. So just give you an honest heads up. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to another Global from Asia podcast. We're here in Science Park with Andrew, and thank you for being here. Andrew, do you mind to introduce yourself to our listeners?
Right. Good afternoon, everyone. Andrew Young is my name. I'm the Vice President for Marketing and Sales at Hong Kong Science Park. The Science Park is the premier science park in Hong Kong. That we are the only major park that nurtures technology and innovation companies in Hong Kong. We have a community currently of close to 500 companies and about 11,000 people working here, fast expanding. And we hope to get the community expanded to probably close to 600 companies and 15,000 people in a couple of years.
Great. Yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful facility. We'll also have to show some pictures because it's audio only, but we'll add some pictures on the show notes.
We can assure you, all you listeners, if you come to Hong Kong, come and visit us, because this is not a typical Hong Kong place that you would imagine. It's spacious, but it provides an excellent open platform for innovators to think alike and people to connect. And it's something quite unimaginable in Hong Kong.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm looking out at the water from our room here. Mm-hmm. And you know, of course, I've been reviewed your website, mm-hmm. and I've known about you guys since I've always been in Hong Kong for 7 years now. Mm-hmm. So it's mostly industries. We're in a biometric building now, and.
Yeah. Bioinformatic. Yeah.
And, you know, I see other industries like electronics, green tech, information technology, telecommunications, precision engineering.
Green technology.
Green technology. Yeah. So that's your main?
Yeah. We focus on these five clusters because they cover some of the traditional industry like electronics in terms of chipset design, power systems, and IT and telecommunication, etc. But the up and rising industries are really the biotech and the green tech. But as we see in the future, industry is so much cutting across over multiple dimensions and multiple industry platforms. So you're no longer you're no longer biotech, because in the future, biotechnology would encumber sensors, would encumber IT, would encumber Internet of Things, wearable devices, data analytics, and then, of course, biology and the pharmaceutical bioproducts. So as we see the development in the future, we see companies cutting across all these sectors. So we have five cluster groups of company, but what we are seeing is a very powerful matrix where company interacts with one another and what we call cross-pollinization, because 1 + 1 = 3, and we see that happening, and that's why companies converge into the science parks, because it is not a place you just lease a space or lab, because you walk downstairs, you see someone else exploring some new ideas. You go to a coffee shop, you go to Starbucks or a Pacific Coffee, or you go to one of our local cafes, people are chatting and say, what do you do? You know, I'm in green tech. Oh, I got a software that may be able to be useful to you. So we see a lot of those interaction happening. This is very much more a campus than a science park.
I got it. Yeah, I mean, just coming in, I saw people networking downstairs. And so these are for how big are normally the companies or...?
I would say about, in terms of number-wise, 4% of our company are larger than 100 employees.
Wow.
Okay, so I would say 80% of the company in the park are smaller, you know, somewhere between 0 to maybe 40 people. So we're mainly SMEs. And this is a characteristic of innovators. Because innovators tend to be small startups, and they do multiple startups. So we're a serial entrepreneur. And we also have successful entrepreneurs who make their bucket of money. And one guy was telling us he has 10 companies in the park.
Wow.
Not because he owns 10 companies, but he was successful in the first one. And he spun off some of his company into other company. And then he started to invest into other companies. So he's now got 10 related companies in the science park. And that's a very powerful message, especially for small company, because they want to look for a place where they can find investors, collaborators, partners, and people who can work together. And this is where it all happens.
Great. So that's pretty amazing. He has 10 companies here.
Yeah.
So what's the normal type of program? I know there's a lot of, you have a lot of different choices. Maybe
yes.
You can go through some ideas.
Yes. We offer what we call, I guess you could loosely call it a pre-incubation kind of program. We have a soft landing platform where a company from abroad or from local could pop in and use a desk. I mean, essentially, they don't come for the desk. They come for the network, the platform, the connections. So when they come, they can join our activities, and then they can interact with other people. We have series of activity where people mingle on certain thematic. We have a theme and kind of a seminar, and people converge to talk about what is the latest. And we may have a speaker coming from abroad, and we say, hey, here's a seminar, and people converge. So from the pre-incubation side, people can converge and rent a desk for a day, a week, you know, or a few weeks, and they can begin to feel the community. And then we have a incubation program where it's a rigorous process they have to apply, and where they're given some support, financial support through rent subsidy. So essentially we subsidize rent, say typically for apps company, they'll be given the use of 2 desks free for 18 months, which okay. is a very good deal. And then for a technology company, they're given 1 year rent free and 2 years half rental. So okay. that goes for 3 years. And the biotech program goes for 4 years, where they get 1 year free and 3 year half. But it's not just a rental subsidy that we offer. It's a lot of the connections, the programs that we engage them in. And we organize training seminar on, we organize mentors. We help them to do product launch. We also help them to win awards and participation awards and get yourself known in the community, etc. And in that result, through that, many of the larger companies become to take notice of this smaller company. So we see a lot of merger and acquisition taking place. So after incubation, they can either leave the park, go outside, but they're still welcome to join the programs, the activities running, or they can just simply lease a space from us and they become a partner company. And on that, they get no more rent subsidies, but they live on. Now, we have a separate program that we nurture these companies in what we call cluster environment. So one example, we're looking at a smart city, possible smart city program in Hong Kong. So if we look at a smart city, what is a smart city? How can we embrace smart cities in the context of Hong Kong? So what we're doing right now is we're gathering all the technology companies in the park and the capability, the technology and the dreams that they have, and we're trying to construe an overall plan, and we're going to take these to the government departments and say, here we have some ideas, and here are all the players involved. And In this, we also engage a university. So when they become a partner company, they're automatically involved in some of these major initiatives that we will take. And that really gives any technology company from abroad and from local a lot of exposure they would not otherwise receive.
Okay. So maybe you can help me with some keywords. I saw like Incu-app. I've heard that actually coming here. I've heard that as a common program. Mm-hmm. And then there's Incu-bio, Incu-tech.
Yeah. These are the three incubation programs.
Programs. So,
and Incu-app is really nurturing innovators that are doing innovative app applications. That's why I give them 18 months, because the 18 months, they should be out. They should it's a short ramp-up period. But we also see one reason that people want to be here is because they can just look across the desk and say, hey, what are you doing? You don't want to repeat the same mistakes that somebody else has done, or someone has already done something, say, can we partner? Let's move on to something else. So that really is an idea.
So maybe you've said it already, but I'm just trying to, the difference maybe is the industry and the length of their program.
Well, it's a length. I mean, Incu-app basically looking at apps that could be applied in smart devices. So typically it's more a downstream app application. Incu-tech, in terms of technology, even if it's an IT type of sectors, we will look at the amount of research and development required. For example, they may be developing a very specific algorithm or a certain architectural framework to construe a software. So it's a more technology platform oriented. And that's why Incu-tech is a 3-year program, whereas app is a year and a half program. But Incu-tech can also cover electronics, green technology, and engineering, product design, etc. Then bio is, again, very, very much different, because the biotechnology cycle is typically much longer than the technology cycle. And that's why with the Incu-bio is a 4-year program. So Incu-app is 18 months, Incu-tech is 3 years, and Incu-bio is a 4 years program.
Got it. Okay. And just referring to your website, the lab services,
yep.
Business support services.
Yep.
So those are on site?
Those are on site. And these really make Science Park very, very unique in the context of Hong Kong. Say, for example, in labs, we have one of the best fitted out lab for biotechnology in Hong Kong. There's nowhere else you can get such facility available apart from university, but university are not there to incubate companies. So when a biotech company needs a commercial facility, if they go to any other sites elsewhere in Kowloon, in Kowloon or Kwun Tong, other area, they have to fit out themselves. It costs them an arm and a leg. So we offer a basic lab, fully fitted out. Plus, we have certain lab equipment, what we call common lab equipment, that small companies don't need to buy. Because if you need an incubator, one of those incubator equipments, that is quite expensive to buy for a small company. But if 10 companies uses it, then we purchase it. They can use it on a timeshare basis. It's a lot more cost effective. Okay. So we included those in part of the basic package and to facilitate this company. And business support services also is one area that most SMEs, when they start up, they're so focused on the technology, they forgot the fact that they need to be trained in how to run a business plan, how to get funding from the bank, etc. So all these are really schemes that could really enable company to really nurture in Hong Kong, which is very, very unique.
And then we talked about the acceleration program, business collaboration is... Yeah. We mentioned earlier where they can cluster. Is that the clustering?
We have another program in the accelerator called the LEAP program, LEAP. The LEAP program is a recently pilot program that we're trying out. What we are doing is picking some of the winners. So we incubate quite a lot of companies. Then we're picking those through a panel system that has a good potential we think that can explode or be scaled up very, very quickly. So we're picking those, giving them extra support, not necessarily money, but giving them extra support through professional advisory, through mentorship, and really guiding this small company into making the right step in development, exploring business potential, and really hitting the sale. So we want this company to be able to scale up very quickly and into a profitable entity.
Got it. And then I think the last one I noticed was the mainland China, the collaboration.
Collaboration, yeah.
Maybe.
Okay. Well, part of really Hong Kong's position Hong Kong is really, I mean, as we all know, Hong Kong is an international city, but we're a very small market. When a company converges into Hong Kong, they look at the potential of mainly the mainland market and also the Southeast Asian market surrounding us. Mainland is very much part of Hong Kong's relationship. And I think it's probably fair to say that we are linked to the southern market, to the Pearl River Delta region, much more than the north. And just that region alone, I mean, something like 60 to 80 million people.
Yeah,
it's really huge. You know, it's the size of Germany. And GDP in the region is much higher compared to other regions. So what we're saying is that in Hong Kong, part of the key important aspect is to how to link to China in the market. And this is what the park is actually playing a certain key role in engaging companies to take them into China. Especially for foreign company, going to China can be quite a maze. It's sometimes very difficult. Even just setting up a company, it's the system and procedure is very much different to that of Hong Kong. So what we do is we help company to be able to set up in sister science park. So what we're using is sister science park's relationship and help them to be set up in those locations so they can get the basic business registration, the tax account, everything sorted out, they can operate very quickly. And in many instances, the company that in the from Hong Kong Science Park entering through those Chinese Science Park enjoys the same benefit that like a local company. So they enjoy it. So we have a reciprocal arrangement. So we introduce our company into their park and they get they get a similar treatment like a local company. When their company comes out, similarly, we offer the same thing. But those relationships really helps the SMEs when they embark onto the Chinese market, which is big, as we all know, but also not a very transparent system. So sometimes it is difficult to venture into those markets themselves. And therefore, through such relationship, they can really get themselves set up quickly, make the right connection, get the product registered, approved, etc., and start selling things. Because essentially, that's what the revenue is what business counts.
Yeah, it sounds really useful. And you said, is it mostly in South China or?
We have depending on the area, we have mostly southern area, but we also have similar arrangements set up in Tianjin and also in Beijing and other places. So we're trying to focus on some clusters, key areas. We have so much approach, so many approach from Chinese Science Park to ask us to be a partner, but we're trying to say, hey, let's focus on certain area because we want to bring benefit to our community.
Yeah, of course, that makes sense there. And we talked a little bit earlier, but maybe about the different companies that are here and startup which kind of programs would a startup go to versus maybe more? Okay. Medium size.
Well, startups typically would join the Incu-tech program. That's what they would usually do. And when they graduate out of that or they become an SME company themselves, then they just sort of join a cluster program. And in cluster program, we are carrying out a full range of support to engage company to mainly to grow and do business. So let me cite one example. Recently, we took, for example, some of the big toy companies in Hong Kong into the park to be engaged with a local technology company. And then we went across sectors, some were in the ICT, some were in the electronics, some were in the precision engineering. And the toy company are looking for innovation, are looking for products, are looking for suppliers. And these small companies say, I'm supplying somebody else, but I can supply the toy industry. So we make that connect. So when they join the cluster program, they're part of this. And either through connection to industry or we help them to link up of accessing talents and research in university to do more innovative research. And then we also take them out to go overseas in trade shows. So we group our company together. So they, a bit like a critical mass. And saying these are the innovators from Hong Kong. So we're doing this in Germany, in the US, in Japan. We bring company outside. So when they join the program, they become part of the community. So whenever we have some initiative, they come with us.
Oh, that's great. So also maybe we can talk about the financial. So of course the campus is amazing, and so that's included for the different program at different amount of time. Mm-hmm. And I know you can also help matchmake with investors. Mm-hmm. Is there any? And there's these travel and trade shows in different parts of the world. Is there like a limit? Is that reimbursement? Is that
typically when they join our program, some of these initiatives like business support services, we don't charge. So it's a totally free of charge. I mean, it's part of our service to the community. When we go overseas for exhibitions, they have to pay their own. But okay. There are funding in the Hong Kong government program that can claim subsidy against those marketing events. So we have a center called Tech One, which is a center helping in the park itself, but helping SMEs and companies in the park finding out all the various funding programs available through the Hong Kong government system. They can get access to those.
Okay.
So they can go to Tech One and they can get all the information. But when we go out, we will say, well, sometimes we will subsidize part of the overall space, but each company will have to pay on their own, like an operational cost. But typically, most of the other services are organized by us, but free of charge. So
okay.
we don't charge the company.
Okay, great. So middle-sized companies that maybe everyone has to apply to be here? And
yes, everyone has to be. And the prerequisite is they must do certain level of research and development. But we're not focusing just on the basic R and the D. We're focusing on the research and also the downstream development part. So the whole idea is you bring innovation technology from conceptual to commercialization. Therefore, our spectrum is quite wide in that perspective of engage. But they must, for example, if someone just purely a sales agent selling something, fit the remit of the parks community, but they have to do so. Every case, we have to do an assessment and ensure that they meet our requirements before.
Okay, and then the application process, is there a certain time?
Yeah, typically no. Well, through the Incu-app program or the Incu-tech program, etc., incubation program, there's a bit of a backlog because, as you know, it's fairly popular. And because of the amount of subsidy we're providing, so we have to administer those with some due diligence. And that might take something like usually maybe 2 months and they'll get a... But in other programs, they join a cluster program. Basically, we have to do a due diligence assessment to see are they bona fide R&D company working out here. Then usually that process takes about also just under 2 months. We do a certain checking of documentation. We sit down with the company, we talk about it, and they put the application in. They understand when they're in, what they inquire, can they do, what can they not do, etc. Then away we go.
Okay. And then I think I found the online, there's like online.
Yeah, there's online application forms. I mean, most of our information, in fact, I've got it on this USB.
Oh,
so
nice.
It's on our website. So we're trying to go for e-platform.
And then is there interviewing too, or?
Yeah, usually we involve a face-to-face meeting between our team and the management team of the company, just to understand who they are, what are they really doing, and try to get a closer understanding. Because we're not here just providing a space. We're here, we're saying to the company, you're here on a journey with us,
okay.
And therefore we need to get to know you, you need to get to know us, and it's a process going along.
Okay. Actually, I did forget to bring up this. The university students? We're near some universities here.
Well, we have a number of the university that have their applied research lab in the park. So they do bring some, they don't use this for teaching, but they use a lot of the researchers are based out in the science park. But we also run one of the largest internship program that we help fund, or we link company in the science part, taking in university intern students, because that's something we really want to encourage, is university students are being nurtured into future talents. They need to be trained, and the company are looking for talents for the future. So linking up science and technology field students to the company in the park, and that's part of the natural interaction that should take place. And that's going on quite well.
All right. And is there a specific program for that, or is it?
We have an internship, but every year we also have a specific recruitment program that we run annual recruitment job fairs that we say company are hiring, come and, and we advertise this throughout the university.
Okay.
But we have a very successful interaction with university students' office where they know where to send the students, we know where to ask for students to come along.
Yeah, sure. Students are always, they're so energetic and great, and they work hard. So it's great to have them. So maybe we can talk about some success stories.
Sure. For example, we have a company called Apple Tech. Incu-tech. It started as an incubation company about 10 years ago. And now they are very successful. They hit about 100 million US a year in terms of turnover. They spend about 20-something percent of revenue on R&D. They keep on investing in R&D. It's one of our six stars. I think we'll be advertising these six stars company. So that's one of the key example. We recently have a company called MadHat, as in MadHat, and they are a games company. And they were incubatees about 5 years ago. But they made to fame a few months ago when someone was trying to acquire 20% of their shares for something like 70 million US.
Wow.
So it's quite a successful company, yeah. And they're expanding very, very fast. And we also have some larger companies that actually are seeing the park as an advantage and joining the base. For example, a local company called GoPeak Electronics GP, they're really into the high-end acoustic products, really high-end electronic acoustic speakers, and they're moving the whole R&D operation into the park.
Wow.
And that spurred a lot of the company in the park of excitement and say, hey, they're here, we can sell our stuff to them. But they're also looking for innovators in the park they can work with. I think that's very important. Another one major company that is joining us is a company called TCL. And TCL now markets mobile phones and in under the Alcatel brand in Europe. And they bought over the Alcatel operation.
Oh, wow.
So they're converging about with 600 people into the park. This will be the core R&D lab of the worldwide operation. So this is where the international experts can really mingle with the local community, that the local staff, and they're putting the 600 people lab in the science park. So these are examples of very large company, but also many of the small company. We are seeing quite a high demand from startups wanting to join the park.
All right. Yeah, and so maybe I think we're getting towards the end. Is there any tips you would give maybe a new company interested in your program or interested in Hong Kong?
Yeah, well, we say, when you come to Hong Kong, come visit us, because seeing is believing, and come and join us. We have also regular events like happy hours and events, so if they connect with us, they can join the community and just get a feel. But importantly, this is like, I keep stressing, this is a campus. It's not a set of buildings. When you go to university campus, you go there to connect with people. You go there to connect with knowledge. You look for partnership. And this is exactly the same. You come here looking for talent, looking for partners in partnership in companies, but also looking for opportunity. And so the park really is a vibrant community, a vibrant ecosystem. So we're saying, seeing is believing. You have to come and experience.
All right.
And just come and join us.
Sounds great. And then best way to start, check your website?
Check our website and send us an email saying I'm interested to come. And
okay.
Then the system will kind of divert people to the right clusters and sectors, because the different people looking after different program, and the system will take care of that and
okay.
Say, we'll make the referral, make sure people are welcome. We got lots and lots of visitors all the time.
All right. Thank you so much, Andrew.
Thank you.
All right. And that's a wrap.
Thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you, Andrew, for sharing. As I said before the interview, the Hong Kong Science and Technology Park is hosting an event from December 1st to December 6th called the Asia Pacific Innovation Summit, or APAC Innovation Summit. It's their annual signature conference, which brings together industry giants, academic experts, and government officials together to promote innovation in the Hong Kong and region around it. This year's theme is Shaping the Future, and will be at the Hong Kong Convention and Exhibition Center. In the show notes of globalfromasia.com/episode54, I'll link to the full details so you can check it all out. Also, some announcements. Julian Lee, which was from Ambig Climate, and he was on our show earlier. Also, Martin Kessler is joining him, and they launched an amazing Kickstarter. I know when we had him on the show, he was on the Singapore crowdfunding system, but he relisted on Kickstarter, and they exceeded their goal in under one day. So I'm really proud of them, and you guys should be too. So congrats, guys. Also, I made a new email account for the podcast, so it's easier for you guys to remember. You can shoot me a direct email at mike@globalfromasia.com. It's going to go right to me, and I'll appreciate any feedback, questions you might have. My Twitter is my last name, Michelini, M-I-C-H-E-L-I-N-I. I love Twitter. And that's it for this show. And keep posted for new shows. And thanks a lot, guys, for listening. Really appreciate it, and wouldn't be anything without you. Bye-bye.
To get more info about running an international business via Hong Kong, please visit our website at www.globalfromasia.com. That's www.globalfromasia.com. Also, be sure to subscribe to our iTunes feed. Thanks for tuning in.